Daily Morning Prayer. Tuesday, July 9th, 2024. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the depths of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness, when your fathers tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my works. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation, and said, It is a people that earn their hearts, for they have not known my ways, of whom I swore in my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. O come, let us adore him. We have heard with our ears, O God. Our fathers have told us what you did in the days of old, how you drove out the nations with your hand and planted our fathers in the land, how you destroyed the nations and cast them out, for they did not possess the land by their own sword, neither was it their own arm that helped them, but by your right hand and your arm and the light of your countenance, because you favored them. You are my King, O God. You sent help to Jacob. Through you we will overthrow our enemies, and in your name will we tread down those who rise up against us. For I will not trust in my bow, it is not my sword that shall help me. But you save us from our enemies and put to shame those who hate us. We make our boasts in God all day long and will praise your name forever. But now you have cast us off and put us to shame, and you do not go forth with our armies. You make us turn our backs upon our enemies so that those who hate us plunder our goods. You let us be eaten up like sheep and have scattered us among the nations. You sell your people for nothing and take no money for them. You make us the reproach of our neighbors. to be laughed to scorn and held in derision by those who are round about us. You make us a byword among the nations, so that the peoples shake their heads at us. My disgrace is daily before me, and the shame of my face has covered me, because of the voice of the slanderer and blasphemer, because of the enemy and avenger. And though all this has come upon us, yet we do not forget you, nor have we been unfaithful to your covenant. Our heart has not turned back, nor have our steps departed from your way, though you have crushed us in the haunt of jackals and covered us with the shadow of death. If we have forgotten the name of our God and held up our hands to any strange god, shall not God search it out? For he knows the very secrets of the heart. For your sake we are killed all the day long and are counted as sheep appointed to be slain. Rise up, O Lord. Why are you sleeping? Awake and cast us not away forever. Why do you hide your face and forget our misery and trouble? Forget our soul, for our soul is brought low even to the dust. Our belly cleaves to the ground. Arise, O Lord, and help us, and deliver us for your mercy's sake. My heart overflows with a noble song. I will sing my words to the king. My tongue is the pen of a ready writer. You are fairer than the children of men. Full of grace are your lips, because God has blessed you forever. Gird your sword upon your thigh, most mighty one, according to your honor and majesty. In your majesty be victorious. Ride out for the sake of truth, to bear witness to righteousness. In your right hand show you marvelous things. Your arrows are very sharp in the heart of the king's enemies, and the peoples shall be subdued under you. Your throne, O God, endures forever. The scepter of your kingdom is a righteous scepter. You have loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness above your fellows. All your garments smell of myrrh, aloes, and cassia. Out of the ivory palaces, stringed instruments have made you glad. King's daughters are among your honorable women. At your right hand stands the queen in a vesture of gold, wrought with many colors. Hearken, O daughter, and consider. Incline your ear, forget your own people and your father's house. So shall the king have pasture in your beauty, since he is your lord, honor him. The daughter of Tyre shall bring you gifts. The rich also among the peoples shall seek your favor. The king's daughter is all glorious within the palace. Her clothing is of wrought gold. She shall be brought to the king in unbroidered raiment. Her virgins, who are her companions, shall bring her to you. With joy and gladness shall they bring her, and shall enter into the king's palace. Instead of your fathers, you shall have sons, whom you shall make princes in all the land. I will make your name to be remembered from one generation to another. Therefore the peoples shall praise you, world without end. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the hills be carried into the midst of the sea, though its waters rage and swell, and though the mountains shake at its tempests. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy dwelling place of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, therefore she shall not be moved. God shall help her at the break of day. The nations are in an uproar, and the kingdoms are moved. But God has lifted his voice. The earth shall melt away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. O come and behold the works of the Lord, what devastations he has brought upon the earth. He makes wars to cease in all the world. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear, and burns the chariots in the fire. Be still then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations, and I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Ruth, beginning with the fourth chapter, the first verse. Now Boaz went up to the gate and sat down there, and behold, the Redeemer of whom Boaz spoke was passing by. So he said, "Come over here, friend, sit down here." And he came down and sat down. Then he took 10 men of the elders of the city and said, "Sit down here." So they sat down. And he said to the Redeemer, "Naomi, who has returned from the land of Moab, has to sell the plot of land which belonged to our brother Elimelech. So I thought that I would inform you, saying, buy it before those who are sitting here and before the elders of my people. If you will redeem it, redeem it. But if you will not, tell me so that I may know, for there is no one except you to redeem it, and I am after you." And he said, "I will redeem it." Then Boaz said, "On the day you buy the field from the hand of Naomi, you must also acquire Ruth the Moabitess, the widow of the deceased, in order to raise up the name of the deceased on his inheritance." Then the Redeemer said, "I cannot redeem it for myself, otherwise I would jeopardize my own inheritance. Redeem it yourself. You may have my right of redemption, since I cannot redeem it." Now this was the custom in former times in Israel concerning the redemption and the exchange of land to confirm any matter. A man removed his sandal and gave it to another, and this was the way of confirmation in Israel. So the Redeemer said to Boaz, "Buy it for yourself." And he removed his sandal. Then Boaz said to the elders and all the people, "You are witnesses today that I have brought from the land, from the hand of Naomi, all that belonged to Elimelech, and all that belonged to Chilion and Mahlon. Furthermore, I have acquired Ruth the Moabitess, the widow of Mahlon, to be my wife in order to raise up the name of the deceased on his inheritance, so that the name of the deceased will not be eliminated from his brothers or from the court of his birthplace. You are witnesses today." And all the people who were in the court and the elders said, "We are witnesses. May the Lord make the woman who is coming into your home like Rachel and Leah, both of whom built the house of Israel. And may you achieve wealth in Ephrathah and become famous in Bethlehem. Moreover, may your house be like the house of Perez, whom Tamar bore to Judah, through the descendants whom the Lord will give you by this young woman." So Boaz took Ruth, and she became his wife, and he had relations with her, and the Lord enabled her to conceive, and she gave birth to a son. Then the woman said to Naomi, "Blessed is the Lord, who has not left you without a redeemer today, and may his name become famous in Israel. May he also be to you one who restores life and sustains your old age. For your daughter-in-law, who loves you, is better to you than 7 sons, and has given birth to him." Then Naomi took the child and laid him in her lap and became his nurse. And the neighbor women gave him a name, saying, "A son has been born to Naomi." So they named him Obed. He is the father of Jesse, the father of David. Now these are the generations of Perez. Perez fathered Hezron. Hezron fathered Ram. And Ram fathered Abinadab. And Abinadab fathered Nashon. and Nasha and Father Salmon and Salmon fathered Boaz, and Boaz fathered Obed, and Obed fathered Jesse, and Jesse fathered David. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to you, Lord God of our fathers. You are worthy of praise. Glory to you. Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you in the splendor of your temple, on the throne of your majesty. Glory to you. Glory to you seated between the cherubim. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you beholding the depths and the high vault of heaven. Glory to you. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. A reading from St. Paul's first epistle to the Corinthians, beginning with the 9th chapter, the first verse. Am I not free? Am I not an apostle? Have I not seen Jesus our Lord? Are you not my work in the Lord? If I am not an apostle to others, at least I am to you, for you are the seal of my apostleship in the Lord. My defense to those who examine me is this: do we not have a right to eat and drink? Do we not have a right to take along a believing wife, even as the rest of the apostles and the prophet and the brothers of the Lord and Cephas? Or do only Barnabas and I have no right to refrain from working? Who at any time serves as a soldier at his own expense? Who plants a vineyard and does not eat its fruit? Or who tends a flock and does not consume some of the milk of the flock? I am not just asserting these things according to human judgment, am I? Or does the law not say these things as well? For it is written in the law of Moses, you shall not muzzle the ox while it is threshing. God is not concerned about oxen, is he? Or is he speaking entirely for our sake? Yes, it was written for our sake, because the plowman ought to plow in hope, and the thresher to thresh in hope of sharing in the crops. If we sowed spiritual things in you, is it too much if we reap material things from you? If others share the right over you, do we not more? Nevertheless, we do not use this right, but we endure all things so that we will cause no hindrance to the gospel of Christ. Do you not know that those who perform secret services eat the food of the temple, and those who attend regularly to the altar have their share from the altar? So also the Lord directed those who proclaim the gospel to get their living from the gospel. But I have used none of these things, and I have not written these things so that it will be done so in my case, for it would be better for me to die than that. No one shall make my boast an empty one, for if I preach the gospel, I have nothing to boast about, for I am under compulsion. For woe to me if I do not preach the gospel. For if I do this voluntarily, I have a reward. But if against my will, I have been entrusted with a commission. Nevertheless, what then is my reward? That when I preach the gospel, I may offer the gospel without charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. For though I am free from all people, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I may gain more. To the Jews I became as a Jew, so that I may gain Jews. To those who are under the law, I became as one under the law, though not being under the law myself, so that I may gain those who are under the law. To those who are without the law, I became as one without the law, though not being without the law of God, but under the law of Christ, so that I may gain those who are without the law. To the weak I became weak, that I may gain the weak. I have become all things to all people, so that I may by all means save some. I do all things for the sake of the gospel, so that I may become a fellow partaker of it. Do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but only one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may win. Everyone who completes the games exercises self-control in all things. So they do it to obtain a perishable wreath, but we an imperishable. Therefore I run in such a way as not to run aimlessly. I box in such a way as to avoid hitting air, but I strictly discipline my body and make it my slave, so that after I have preached to others, I myself will not be disqualified. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain. For with your blood you have redeemed for God from every family, language, people, and nation, a kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor, forever and forevermore. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. O Lord, be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, the Spirit to think and do always those things that are right, that we who can do no good who can do no good thing apart from you, may by you be enabled to live according to your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life, and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and send your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised through your world beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant our requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world the knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation, in the church, and in Christ Jesus forever and ever.